Hello there for all the photographers, videographers, vloggers like me who loves their photography gear so much. I know that we invested a lot of money onto our gears, onto our cameras, into our lenses, right? So I think it is, for me, it is right to say that we also have to take care of those stuff. For us vloggers, for us photographers, or for us videographers, without our camera, we are paralyzed. So I think it is right for me to say that we have to treat them as if it is one of the important part of our life. And with that being said, guys, it is very, very important to store our gears in a dry place. And when I say dry place, it is in a percentage of comfort to our electronics. So I'm actually talking about here the humidity. So now, what is a dry box? I want you to imagine, guys, a refrigerator or a freezer, and there you have a dry box. However, instead of maintaining the cold temperature inside it, this particular container controls the humidity of our tools. No matter the temperature, it maintains the relative humidity. Now, what is important of a dry box? Why do we have to have a dry box? Only one word that can answer that question. That is a fungus. That is the number one enemy of our gears, of our lenses, and of our cameras, guys. If you're going to look at your lens and you will see some kind of a root, or let's say a snowflakes-like kind of image, it's not actually a crack, guys. It's fungus. So guys, if you're going to ask yourself, do I really need a dry box? That would depend on how often you use your camera gears, guys. But sometimes we are too busy of doing things that we just put the cameras on the drawer, on the bag, which has the environment that is conducive for forming of fungus or mold inside it. We all know that we have a very unpredictable weather, guys. It's very dangerous for our cameras and lenses because of the condensation. So when you say condensation, basically there will be a moisture inside the body, and that is very, very, very conducive for the molds to form. But guys, if you use your cameras very often, let's say almost every day, you don't really need a dry box, because here in the Philippines, we know that we have a lot of sunlight, and if we're going to expose our cameras in the sun or in the light of the sun, that is the number one enemy of molds. But sometimes we have to store them in a dry place, such as a dry box. And there are two types of dry box, guys. First is the electronic dry box. If you prefer to adjust the humidity level of a dry box on your own, the electric dry box is perfect for you. But it's a little bit expensive, yes. But you know, if you have a lot of gears, if you have invested a lot of money for your gears, why not invest also in something that could protect them? If you don't really use them that much often, you really, really need a dry box, such as the electronic dry box. Okay, guys, the second type of a dry box is what we're going to do right now, and that is a desiccant dry boxes or a desiccant dry box. If you want to have a simple, a cheaper cabinet for your cameras and lenses, so this type is sealed, airtight box that contains a silica gel or any other desiccants. It's easy to manage and more affordable than the electric type. The only disadvantage of a dry box like this is that if you're going to open it often, the desiccant might become saturated with moisture, thereby defeating the purpose of a cabinet. This dry cabinet does not come with a regulator or a controller. That's why we will need a specific device to control the humidity of our dry box. So we will go to that later. Ideal RH, or the ideal relative humidity of our dry box, is between 35 to 45%. I would like to tackle this one because there are some people who think that the drier the better. When it comes to electronic, guys, that is not the case. Inside our electronics, there are what you call some kind of a mechanism, and through that mechanism, it needs to be lubricated. If the environment is too dry, there is a big tendency that the lubrication inside our cameras will also dry out. So that will cause more harm for our cameras. So we don't want that to happen. That is actually worse than molds. 45% and above, conducive for molds or fungus. 35% and below, there will be a risk for the lubrication to dry out. So now you know. Okay, guys, so let's go to the equipments that we will be needing in order for us to materialize our DIY dry box. So the first thing that we'll be needing is, of course, an empty airtight box. We will know if it is an airtight box, if it has some rubber lining on the cover, and of course, it is also indicated in the label. Next is a towel, or you can also use a microfiber cloth and a thin foam if you have. Next is the silica gel or the desiccant gel. There are also what you call a dehumidifier, but I choose not to use that because it collects a lot of water, guys. And I don't want to risk that by putting it beside my gears. So that is a no. Next is the hygrometer. So hygrometer is very important. So this device here is the one that's going to monitor relative humidity of our dry box. And of course, our photography, videography, and vlogging gears. So now guys, this is the time that I'm going to show you how to create a dry box. A step-by-step process, as easy as 1, 2, 3, to make your dry box more organized. And I hope you learned something from this, guys. See you again on the next one. Bye-bye. Bye.